Welcome back with us here on Leaders of Tomorrow. And tonight, on our Small Giants segment, the focus is on Utkalamrita. Odia is renowned for its local crafts and handloom. However, there's been little done to endorse this art on a global platform. That's where MSMEs can step up to create awareness and promote this sector through unique and innovative ideas that modify existing designs of the age-old handcraft sector. Utkalamrita is a Bhuvaneshwar-based startup that's working towards providing authentic handloom and fabric the international popularity that it deserves. Karishma Vanjani caught up with the founder to bring you more on this story. Take a look.
So several months ago, this unbelievably tenacious young woman reached out to me on social media suggesting that I look at her handloom textiles from Odisha. That was my first encounter with Amrita, and I've never looked back. There's nothing like the friendship and camaraderie and working relationship that we have developed around the textiles and crafts from Odisha. And every time I drape a sari like this one or wear a crop top like this one made for me by my dear friends, I am full of gratitude, not only to them, but to all of the weavers and craftsmen in Odisha who make these things that I am privileged to enjoy.
Authentic sarees of Odisha, be it a ikat, potochitra or a sambalpuri, they are all hard to match. However, due to low promotion and poor innovation in this age-old handloom sector, Odisha's craft seems to be dying. But don't worry, our entrepreneurs of today will be our saviors of tomorrow. Utkalamrita, a startup in the capital city of Odisha, is leveraging the expertise of the local artisans here to take this art global.
So Anita, what made you create Utkalamrita and what are some of the ways that you're mobilizing Odisha's local craftsmen and weavers?
So me and my sister, we started Utkalamrita to focus on Odisha's wonderful handicrafts and handlooms. So Utkala means Utkarsha Kala, that means the land of exquisite arts and crafts. And Amrita means nectar, which is also my sister's name. So Utkalamrita means the nectar of Utkala, that is Odisha. Nectar of Utkala is handicrafts and handlooms and the wonderful heritage and culture which we want to offer to the world. And that's how we started this. And we wanted the weavers and the artisans who are out of work and who are moving on to other professions to be employed and to carry on the traditions of the state. We want our arts and crafts to be available all over the world, and we are providing employment to so many.
The startup has been widely focusing on taking Odisha's crafts global through international fairs and exhibitions. What has been the overseas response in terms of the sales generated?
In the first year, mostly we visited international fairs, three exhibitions we went, and most of our sales were from abroad, from international fairs. So 11 lakhs was our turnover in the first year of our operation. Thereafter, in the second year, it was 15 lakhs turnover. And for this present year, till date, it has crossed 15 lakhs. So that means like international exhibitions mostly have contributed to about 40% of our total turnover. But except for the first year in which most of it was from there.
Okay. So what has been the response overseas? How welcoming have the consumers been?
The consumers have been very delighted to see our products. And not only our products, but also our Odia script also, in which we wrap our products in the newspapers, which have Odia newspapers. Okay. So they are very happy to see that also, the sixth classical language of India. So apart from that, all the products, of course, they like to take, and what's best is they are customizing it as per their requirement. Like in Malaysia, they got it stitched in their local costume, our ikat sari, and they posted the picture on Instagram.
So to reach the Chinese consumers, the Ministry of MSME through the MDA scheme did support you financially. It did provide you a sum of 1.25 lakhs to reach these consumers. I want to understand, what has been your overall experience with the government?
That was the first time when we got any grant from the government, from Department of MSME, which was supporting the women entrepreneurs. So we were one of the 16 firms selected from all over India, and we took part in the Chengdu International Festival. And it was great, except for the fact that they just provided this travel fare, air ticket fare for one person, and the stall cost they arranged for that. But rest of it we had to pay from our own, because two of us were traveling, and the stay, travel, lodging, food, everything comes to us. Like, we are spending our own capital for that.
Expounding on the government support that you've received, the Directorate of Export Promotion and Marketing has been set up in Odisha specifically to help SSI units such as yours. Has there been any backing from their end?
We are afraid that we are not very happy with the support we have received so far, because despite giving so much feedback and what better they can do about it, not much is being done. In fact, every year there's one Kunming International Trade Fair that happens, one of the biggest consumer fairs of the world, for which the government of Odisha supports that. But this year, first time it happened that the ad came out, and despite us having applied, the fair was cancelled from the DPM's end, and many exporters had applied for that, which speaks poorly.
Okay. Do you think it's because of the limited funds by any chance?
The government has the funds and should be using it to support entrepreneurs like us. Most of the trips which we have taken is out of our own funds.
So Utkalamrita follows an omni-channel approach. It caters to its consumers through its offline centers and an online channel. What is your preferred mode of sale?
We feel that both the modes should be used, because both online and offline are important. So our products were first listed online on the day of the Nabha Jovana Darshana, which is the day when the visitors can get to see Lord Jagannath for the first time in his new form. So that visit was our new birth. We feel that online has helped a great deal. So online marketplaces are there. But more than that, what has helped us is the social media. WhatsApp, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter. We are using all modes to go all out.
Since we're talking about price points here, I want to talk about GST. The sale of Sambalpuri sarees, one of the very well-known handloom product of Odisha, has taken a hit post-GST. Many of the weavers are saying that's because of the increase in price of the yarn and the colour. How have you negated this impact?
Yeah, post GST, we have had to spend around rupees 100 to rupees 500 more per sari, depending on the weave. So, because the prices have increased, yes. But then we have also told it to the customers, and they agree that we need to compensate the weavers for that. At least for Utkalamrita, our sales haven't diminished.
So the consumers haven't brought the price of the GST?
Yeah, the consumers are willing to pay, and they understand.
So Anita, let me quickly wrap up this interview and talk to you about the youth of Odisha. Many of them are staying away from weaving and crafting because they're discouraged by profitability of this profession. What is your one message for them?
My message for the entrepreneurs would be that you please promote and popularize our Odisha handicrafts and handlooms, and let us be brand ambassadors. And these days it's very easy in the case of online marketing. We can show our products to the world. And I would also like to give a message for our weavers and artisans that you please continue the tradition and do not be swayed by other lucrative professions. Let us create demand for our products and bring it to the world stage. Let us all be brand ambassadors of our state and of India.
Thanks a lot, Anita, for joining us on Leaders of Tomorrow.
Thank you.
that's our show tonight. If you have any feedback for us, you can always write in at leadersoftomorrowtimesgroup.com. On social media, tweet at me at Sunanda_J or LOT_ET now. Our Facebook page is Leaders of Tomorrow on ET Now. You can also call us on that number you see on your screen. Thanks very much for watching. Have a good night.